Hey everyone, it's Neve and welcome to my Mixed Media channel. Today we're going to be looking at using collage tissue and stencils on a journal page. So the inspiration for this, I wasn't really planning anything in particular, but I really wanted to use the Jane Davenport collage tissue papers because I've got a stack of them and I haven't really used them. They're two-ply like serviettes, so taking off the plain white backing of one and just pasting down the coloured side onto my art journal using collage medium to spread out onto the page loosely. So I'm using two different designs here, the ink splats and the palette. I'm using my paint palette to spread the collage medium over top just to make sure it's really firmly affixed to the page. You can see I've tore the page because it's a little bit over ambitious with my rubbing, but I'm just filling it up because I know I'm going to be putting more layers over the top. If you're really concerned about it, you could use a wide flat brush and do it really gently, or you can just slap it on like me and think of it as extra texture. So using my heat gun to dry the page, and now I'm adding more colour by using the Dina Wakeley heavy-bodied paints in lots of bright colours. The thing I really love about these paints is the fact that they stand up really well against each other. Because they are heavy-bodied, you really have to rub them together to get them to mix. They do mix beautifully when you want them to, but they also dry quite quickly when you're rubbing them on thinly like this, and you can see how well they stand up out against each other. So you can put your yellows and your purples together and make them really pop. Using a Dina Wakeley, the bullseye stencil, going over with a wet wipe to do a ghosting effect, and then pressing the extras on the bit, doing a bit of a journal flip through my use it up junk journal to clean off my stencil, something that I don't do very often. Again, just drying the layers as I go so I can build on top of them. So next layers I'm going to go in with some archival ink. Again, I think this is it's either the Dina Wakeley or the Dilusions set of four inks, archival inks. So using the pink on this one, and some lovely person on YouTube did tell me that the Crosses stencil is from the Crafters Workshop. It's one of my favourites at the moment, as is the Tim Holtz one you just saw with the dots in different sizes. So just adding into the boring areas, I suppose, some extra texture and some extra colour just to fill in the gaps. At this stage I still didn't really know where I was going with this. I just wanted to play with layers and building up layers. It's something I'm really interested in the moment. I did know that I wanted to use these double girls on the page somewhere though, because I really love them. They're funky haircuts. They remind me of something out of Doctor Who, or the old Egyptian books I used to pore over when I was a kid. So I'm just outlining around the rough area of the main focal image, because I want to paint the back in with white so that it actually stands out quite clearly. I don't want it to get lost with the highly coloured background. Again, just painting in the background with the collage medium, using that instead of the thicker, ultra-thick medium, because the paper is so fine, the ultra-thick tends to not go as thinly onto the page or as evenly, so you do tend to get a few more lumps and bumps, and you're more likely to tear the final image. So while I was doing that, I was thinking about those circles in the background, and I saw this piece, which had lots of different faces on it, and something that's been bubbling in my mind is in a lot of the art groups that I'm involved in at the moment, I've been really enjoying the fact that everyone's so supportive and everyone's got each other's back, and that strong network, not completely of women, but the majority of it is with women, and they've been very supportive of me and my endeavours and what I've been doing, which I really appreciate. So that's sort of what I was thinking about when I got to this part of the art journal. You've got the two main women at the front and all these other people behind them supporting them, kids, parents, family members, friends, and so on. So using the same process, gluing them down the page, because I want them to blend in more, I haven't painted the background white. I want them to sort of blend in. You can see the layers underneath. They're sort of there in really in the background. While I was doing this, I was sort of thinking I want to have something to put together. Now, usually I have a quote or something bubbling in my mind. I knew I wanted to be something about strong women in a tribe, but while I was doing this, I couldn't for the life of me think of something I wanted to write on the page. So I get out my scribble sticks, ready to colour in the main page, and I do love the pigmentation of these sticks. I've found that I enjoy using them best if I just actually dip them straight into the water and paint on with them. You just get such a rich colour with them. And they really bright up. So that's the cheddar. I think it was peacock used here. These are the second edition of the scribble sticks. And I think they're my new favourites. I did like the colours in the original one, but I like the colours in this one even better. Particularly marine's one of my favourites at the moment, and this eggplant colour I'm using at the moment. So they go on really, really smoothly. They give you a really loose line. They dry quite quickly as well, which is good, and they're blendable by hand when they're a bit wet. Again, you'll see me get my fingers in again. Just outlining the outside of them with the marine just to give that darker shadow, and again to pop those images out of the page slightly and let the background recede. So at this stage I was still trying to wrap my brain about what I was going to write, what I was going to do, and at some stage I grabbed my iPad and go to Pinterest to have a look up some quotes, and I think I typed in strong women or a tribe of women to find a quote. You can see me looking through there, and it was really interesting. There's some lovely quotes actually that I might go back and use again. I've always had a really strong fascination with text and with typography, and I've absolutely fallen in love with these Tim Holtz foam stamps. I've only got three sets of them. I've got this wood, almost wood block cut, and the lowercase version of that, and the script at the moment, but I think I'm going to have to source the other ones because they're just amazing. I love the foam because you can use them with the ink really successfully, but you can also brayer over them with paint, and they stand up quite well to that instead of putting it onto your rubber stamps. Usually I try and measure out where things are going, but I didn't on this page. Luckily most of it fitted in. So behind every successful woman is a tribe of other successful women who have got her back. So it worked quite well, apart from the very last bit, who have got her back. So I decided that I'd write it on with a food ball pen, and I hated my handwriting. So very luckily, because I put so many layers on, and because it had the clear gel medium over the top, it rubbed off with a wet wipe. And while I was waiting for that to dry a bit, put away my stamps and tried again to write it this time. Oh, sorry, I'm darkening up some of the letters that didn't stamp so successfully. So I decided to use a paint pen, but again, didn't particularly like it, didn't think about spacing, so I went in again to finish that off. So here are a close-up of the finished page. I really love doing this page. I love the layers in it, and I love the sentiment behind it. It really spoke to me and spoke about what's happening in my artistic journey at the moment. I really hope you enjoy it, and if you like this video, like to see more, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.